Hello everyone. Today in this module we will learn about another important book in accounting, that is ledger. We all know that transactions are first entered in journal or special purpose subsidiary books like cash book, purchase book, sales book, purchase return book and sales return book. Then in the next step, the entries from journal or these subsidiary books will be transferred to their related head, their related account, and where this account is being maintained, it is maintained in the ledger. So it is a chief book of accounts, and it is in this book that all business transactions would ultimately find their place under their accounts in a duly classified form. And this is the format of the account in the ledger. In the center, you will write down the name of the account. On the left hand side, you will write down debit. On the right hand side, you will write down credit. And total of 8 columns will be there. First column for the date, second for particulars, third for journal folio, JF. Fourth column for amount, and the same of these columns, these 4 columns that will appear on the credit side. In the date column, we mention the date of the transaction. In particulars, we write the name of the other account which is affected by the transaction other than this account that we have mentioned here. In JF or journal folio, we will write down number of the page number of the journal or subsidiary book from which that particular entry is being transferred, and amount, that will specify the amount pertaining to this account in this transaction. And this process of transferring entries from journal or subsidiary books to the ledger, first we have entered the transaction in journal, and then we are taking this transaction to the respective accounts in the ledger. This process is termed as the posting. Now let us take an example. Like, you have sold goods for cash, rupees 20,000. Then you will enter in the journal cash account debit to sales account 20,000. Now how many heads are there? Two heads. One is your cash account and second one is your sales account. So you will open two heads in the ledger. One is cash and one will be your sales. First, cash account. Just look at this account. Cash account. Format already we have discussed. Now, cash account is being debited. So you will write on the debit side of cash account. This is the cash account and this side is the debit side. And here we have to write the name of the other account which is being affected by the transaction, and this other account is sales account. So here you will write down sales account, and how much debit is there in the cash account? 20,000. So here you will write down 20,000. Now how you will show it in the sales account? On the credit side. And what is the name of other account in the sales account? By cash account. Just look at this transaction very carefully. This is the basic rule how you can post transaction from journal to ledger. In the journal, it will appear like this. In the ledger, it will appear like this. Let us take second example. Sold goods for rupees 20,000 to Ram, out of which rupees 12,000 received in cash. Now, how will it be posted? First, you will write down the entry. Cash account debit, Ram debit to sales account. So now, how many accounts will be there in the ledger for this transaction? Total of 3 accounts. One will be cash account. One will be cash account. Second will be Ram. And third will be sales account. Cash, it is being debited. both the accounts are being debited, cash and RAM, and from against which account they are being debited, sales account. So in cash account as well as in RAM account, in particulars what we will write down, to sales, like this. Okay, and how much debit cash is getting? 12,000. And how much debit will be there in RAM account? 8,000. 12,000, 8,000. Now sales account, there is a total credit of 20,000, but from how many accounts it has got this credit? Two accounts, cash account and RAM account. So in the sales account you will write down, by cash account 12,000, by RAM 8,000. This is how you can post the transaction from journal to ledger. After posting, next step is our closing and balancing of the accounts. We all know there are three types of accounts: personal, real and nominal. In personal account, what we need to find out at the year end, out whether we owe to that person or that person owe to us. So if the debit of any account is more, then balance will be written on the credit side by balance carried down, only for the purpose of balancing, but that person is our debtor. And if the reverse is there, if credit side is more, then balancing figure will be written on the debit side, but it represents which balance? Credit balance. With Ram, during this month we have two transactions. These two transactions are there with Ram. Okay, so in the first transaction we have posted two sales, 8,000. Sold goods for rupees 20,000 to Ram, out of which rupees 12,000 received in cash. So only rupees 8,000 were debited to Ram. Then on 15, received rupees 2,000 from Ram. Here you will post it by cash account. Now if we balance this account, 8,000 minus 2,000, difference is 6,000, and which side is more? Debit. So balance will be written on the credit side by balance carried down. Second account is the real account or the assets account. Here I feel I don't need to tell you the rule, because assets have debit balances. So always their balance will be written on the credit side by balance carried down. Like cash account, here you have written two sales, 8,000, by purchases 2,000. So the balancing figure will be 6,000, representing the debit balance, and written on which side? Credit side, by balance carried down. Third type of account is the nominal account. That means the accounts relating to expenses and incomes of the firm. These do not require balancing, because expenses, they will show the debit balance, and incomes, they will show the credit balance. And secondly, nominal accounts at the year end, these will be closed directly by transferring their balance to the trading account or the profit and loss account, depending upon their nature. Just take an example, rent account. Like we have written two cash account, 4,000. We need not balance this account. Similarly, purchases account, sales accounts are there, like purchases here. This is representing the cash purchase and this one is representing the credit purchase. But you need not balance this account. It will represent a total of rupees 4,90,000 debit balance. So this is how you can post the transaction from journal to ledger, and how can you total and balance the ledger accounts. In the next module, we will study about preparation of trial balance. Till then, good day to all of you.